Instead, dear life, dear ones, life only responds to you, responds to your actions, responds to your beliefs, responds to all that you choose to create. It is a response, dear one, that exists outside of a thinking mind, for the responsive nature of manifest creation is built into the workings of the forms themselves. There is no oversight. There is no judging mind foreseeing all of creation, wishing you to suffer, wishing harm to come to those who do wrong. Instead, dear ones, there is simply response. Response from your manifest creation. Response from the energy that this form, existing as your body, as your energy fields, as your thinking mind, response from all the vibrations of expression that this form is experiencing. It is quite simple, dear ones. There is no judge. There is only you, existing as the one consciousness, existing as the consciousness creating all form. And the form itself, dear ones, is endowed with the action of constant changeability, of changing itself based upon the vibration inherent within all forms. Dear ones, look at the manifest world as one living organism, not as separate beings, but as one unified living organism. It changes. It responds to itself within itself. It is a natural occurrence, such as the fields of vibration meeting. You have two tuning forks, dear ones. Two tuning forks upon which are striked. Striking this tuning fork will resonate. Striking another one in a different key will create a different vibration. Yet putting these two different vibrational tuning forks next to each other, you will find them, dear ones, resonating in a harmony. For that, dear ones, is an illustration of the manner of creation and the law of response in this manifest world. All of life is vibrating, communicating within itself, creating manifest experiences, constantly creating equilibrium, constantly creating harmony within itself as the vibrational field of consciousness that it is, as the vibrational forms that exist within your world. So, dear ones, there is no judge. None of your actions are separate. For all that you see and all that you perceive, all that you do has been influenced by all of life. You think yourself, dear ones, to be a separate being, to have separate choices and separate decisions. Yet we tell you, dear ones, that even the thoughts within your consciousness have been created by all of manifest reality. This may be more than for your conscious mind to grasp, for your conscious mind may still identify as a separate being. But we tell you, dear ones, that the thoughts within your mind are not yours alone. They have been created, dear ones, by all that you've heard, by all that you've seen, by all that you've been told. Let us take this example, dear ones. You have been told a belief by a parent, and now you express this belief within your life. Now let us find, dear ones, the source from whence this belief has come, for you may believe, dear ones, that it is you as a separate being who is creating this belief. Or you may, dear ones, say this belief came from your parents, and you may choose to blame this thinking pattern upon your parental units. But let us look more fully, dear ones. You have this belief, which was given to you by your parents. And your parents, dear one, received this belief from their parents. And their parents, dear one, received this belief from their parents. And on it goes, a chain of successive beliefs stemming back through your generational units, through your DNA structure, through your vibrational frequency that you are manifesting here as your physical body and as your mental mind. Yet know, dear ones, that the belief that your grandparents were given from their parents was not given only from their parents alone. This belief, dear one, was shared and added to by all of society around them, by their brothers and sisters, by their friends and family, by their neighbors and their foes. So, dear ones, can you see that the beliefs that you hold within your mind have not been created by you, not been created by this selfish person you believe yourself to be, by this personality that you believe is separate, is alone in this world? For dear ones, you form identity around the beliefs within your mind, thinking yourself to be the creator, determining your self-worth based upon the ideas that you hold, judging yourself, dear ones, to be good, to be strong, to be better than those around you simply because of the beliefs that exist within your mind. Yet these beliefs, dear ones, were not created by you. These beliefs, dear ones, are shared within all of human consciousness, within all of eternity itself. For we are one unified whole, one consciousness creating itself in each eternal moment. Consciousness, dear ones, one continual being. All forms existing within this consciousness as the self, as your true source. Now, dear ones, you believe yourself to be separate. You believe yourself to be unworthy. You believe yourself as needing forgiveness. Yet we tell you, dear ones, there is no judge. There is only one life continually creating itself, continually resonating, finding equilibrium amongst the forms. Dear one, it is only you. It is only who you believe yourself to be that has created the belief of a judge, has created the belief of a divine being sitting amongst you, sitting above you, judging your actions, condemning you to suffering. It is simply a belief, dear ones, a belief that has been passed along through this planet, given to you by your parents, from your parents' parents, from your great-grandparents, from all the generations along your ancestral line. And dear ones, these beliefs were not yours alone. They are shared by humanity, by all of humanity, by all of the collective consciousness that is existing within this world.